After 2 weeks, the world's spin has slowed by nearly 15 kilometers an hour. And the chain reaction gained speed. Commercial aviation has been reduced to essential services only, with a record 470 accidents worldwide. More than 2.25 billion passengers fly commercially every year. But now, as safety concerns grow, flights are canceled. Americans also make more than 10 billion trips on buses and trains annually. Now that number soars as airline passengers look for other ways to travel. Time is the first problem on an Earth that is slowly losing its spin. But after 2 weeks, there is a new, even more critical problem. The oceans. Our planet bulges. It's fatter in the middle than at the poles. Our spin is one of the forces that keeps the water in place on top of the equator. But as that force weakens, the oceans begin to move. Seas start flowing away from the bulging equator toward the poles. More than 1 billion cubic kilometers of water are on the move. Northern places, like the Canadian Arctic, are the canary in the coal mine. 3 months after the Earth begins to slow down, among the first hit are cities in the tropics, including Rio, Mumbai, and Singapore. It's getting increasingly hard to breathe here. Further north, cities at higher elevations are also beginning to struggle. In the United States, people climbing in Colorado experience the effect dramatically. Altitudes of 1,500 meters are now like breathing at 4,500. Humans can begin to experience altitude sickness at less than 2,500 meters. Just over 5,000 meters is the outer limit of survival. The world is changing quickly, and the worst is yet to come. Four months have passed since the Earth started losing its spin. We're now spinning more than 225 kilometers an hour slower than we used to. Each day is almost 28 hours long, meaning 2 more hours of daylight and 2 more of darkness. Problem. earthquakes, where there have never been earthquakes before. The Earth has three layers, a molten core, a solid insulating mantle, and a hard outer crust. They all rotate together. But as our spin decreases, each layer slows at a different speed, unleashing massive friction. The Earth is literally ripping itself apart from the inside out. The waters off San Francisco are an area prone to earthquakes. But now, oceanographers here see evidence of seismic activity that they've never seen before. Deep cracks in the ocean floor release intense heat. Dead fish, killed by the blast, float to the surface.
Volcanic activity in and around Chicago has shut down several major arteries. Experts are advising that anyone who can't stay home today should do so.
Geological disasters are just one of the extreme effects of a slowing Earth. The moving oceans are just as wild. Less centrifugal force means the oceans continue to flow from the bulging equator, steadily advancing to the poles. The ocean in the Arctic was once more than 4,500 meters deep. Now, it's more than 13,000. All that water has come from oceans to the sun, and shallow areas, like the English Channel, dry out as waters drain to the poles. For the only time in recorded history, Britain is part of mainland Europe, and Ireland is connected to England. You can now walk from London to Paris. It's not just Europe. Miami's famous beaches are now inland as the oceans surge to the poles. Cuba and Florida are connected by land, and Mexico's about a third bigger than it was. It's not only water that's on the move. As the Earth's rotation weakens, the atmosphere is now starting to settle toward the top and bottom thirds of the globe. These are the only places people can breathe. New York. London. Toronto. Are all safe. But Mexico City and other major urban areas to the south are now doomed. Their air too thin to breathe. In the United States, Denver is called the mile-high city, as the atmosphere thins, but now feels like it's almost 5 kilometers high, with an air pressure that's like breathing more than halfway on Everest.
Experts believe
the
air will remain breathable in lower elevations.
Water is flooding in from the north, and air is thinning from the south. But a few small pockets of habitable land still exist in the middle of North America. Staying in Denver is a death sentence. For young and old, the effects are already critical. Soon, the air will be lethal for them.
The U.S. government advises that up to 25 million people in parts of the Southwest should evacuate.
The slowing rotation of the Earth unleashes deadly friction between Earth's outer layers and the inner molten core. Volcanoes and earthquakes have destroyed routes by road and rail.
Major highways across the country are closed, and those traveling by car are warned that there are no safe routes.
Making the treacherous journey into the livable middle of the United States, witness the geological upheaval caused by the slowing Earth. While earthquakes devastate the Midwest, retreating oceans coastal cities high and dry. New York, Boston, Halifax, far inland. Australia has formed a new continent with Indonesia. And Asia's shallow coast is no longer a coast at all. In just 4 months, Hong Kong and other major ports are dry. Shipping has come to a standstill all around the world. Others are discovering the slowing Earth has a new danger: death by solar radiation. An invisible electric field called the magnetosphere normally protects the Earth. The field is maintained by our planet's spin. Rapid rotation of the Earth's iron core generates. The magnetosphere deflects blasts of solar radiation. But as our spin slows, the magnetic field is weakening, and our protective shield is breaking down. Tropical places like Miami are in no danger of flooding. The city sits on the Atlantic's continental shelf. Now, dozens of kilometers of that shelf are exposed, and Miami is landlocked. And here, the air is still breathable, but the sun is deadly. It's been just over a year since our rotation began to slow. We are now spinning almost 340 kilometers an hour less than we used to. The face of the planet continues to change. The waters of the Earth are still moving. And a year since it became possible to walk from England to France, it will never be possible again. At first, the shallow areas around mainland Europe drained as the North Atlantic Ocean converged on the pole. But now, as the polar sea swells, United Kingdom and much of Europe are swallowed by the new world. London is gone. Berlin, gone. Moscow, gone. Historical cities of Northern Europe, all at the bottom of a new sea. Hundreds of millions of people lived here. In North America, survivors who have been able to make the trip begin to arrive in Kansas. A college campus has been coming here. Scientists are working to create a refuge in what they think is the safest place in the United States, no disaster on a scale we've never had to deal with. The survivors who have made it here are on their own. It will be a struggle, and they are the lucky ones.
Tồn tại rất nhiều là sinh vật. Quá trình xảy ra là những chỗ những lỗ thông này. Cái dây á. Người người xây nhà à? Anh Nghĩa anh ấy luôn, anh cao nhất luôn. Mười trai các anh thì bảo nói chuyện bảo là cái gì đàn em xây nhà cũng không có phép biết thì có gì anh nói em cái để anh về đây anh 10 triệu luôn. Không, mình nói mình cứ đưa luôn. Nói chung là giá nếu mà anh nhà sinh nhà to cái đứa nhà nhà em thì là 10 triệu đúng. Đứa ít quá sợ ông nhận tiền. À, ngang 15 sâu 10. Trăm và tí nếu mà anh xây xin lâu quá thì anh đưa 7 8 triệu rồi. Cái nhà nhỏ. Em mới tốt.
Cổ đại, loài động vật phát nguồn nguy hiểm, có phong cách săn, tính tố hơn là chúng ta. cách đây 60 cửa hàng. Chúng đã được thoát khỏi khu vực Bắc Mỹ.
Tính giờ gặp anh Nghĩa à? Đợt đấy em xe thì là anh Nghĩa Minh Trung. Trung có giờ chuyển lên huyện Phú Riềng à. Đấy, thì đấy thì gặp anh Nghĩa rồi.
Thank you.